Hi, and welcome back to our seventh video, where we are going to build our DevSecOps pipeline with GitHub. In this video, we are going to look how we can prevent that secrets are committed into our branch, which is secret protection. In our past videos, we had a look at our DevSecOps pipeline, which we are building with GitHub. In our past six videos, we had a look at how to build such a DevSecOps pipeline with GitHub. We built our pipeline, then we identified what kind of dependencies we have, then we scanned for licenses, and we did the static application security testing and afterwards the container scanning. In this video, we are now going to look for secrets that are in our code. And we want to identify these secrets, and we also would like to prevent that new secrets are added in our source code. So, Padi, how do we do that with GitHub?
In contrast to what we did until now, secret detection is built-in functionality of GitHub. This means we basically configure everything within GitHub and the user interface there. By the way, secrets refers to typically API keys and similar stuff. So secret detection is about finding secrets in the code that you've written or in configuration files you provide. Secret detection is enabled automatically for free and public repositories. It's even mandatory there. If you want to enable it on private repositories, you need GitHub Enterprise and the Advanced Security tab within that. So secret detection is implemented like this. It scans all your source code files and config files you committed to the Git repository. In the Git repository, it looks for secrets like APIs keys or whatever you defined that a secret should look like. By giving you a hint that it detected such secrets, it gives you a chance to replace this secret. Replacing, by the way, is basically the only remediation you can do, else the secrets could be abused. So whenever GitHub detects secrets, this means you must revoke the secrets in whatever tool they are for.
So, Padi, in DevOps, we always say everything is source code and all of our source code should go to the repository. But where do I store now my secrets if I cannot store them in the source code?
Good question. Well, for secrets, this doesn't apply. Secrets should be stored in places explicitly created for them. As we've seen in the SAS session, one good place would be the secret section within the settings of the repository. This is a specially protected area provided by GitHub by default. An alternative that's also supported by GitHub would be, for example, a Azure-based key vault. So these are the places where secrets belong to, not into config files or code files. Enabling secret detection is quite easy. You go to the Code Security and Analysis section within the Settings tab of your repository. There you find the Advanced Security section and the Secret Scanning item. You enable that and you may, in addition, enable push protection for secrets at the same place. Please note that it will take some time until GitHub initially scans your repository history and reports back to you. GitHub will report its findings in different places. First, you can find it within the security tab of the GitHub user interface. There you just head to secret scanning. In addition, you may receive emails when GitHub detects new secrets. Exactly who receives these emails can be configured. And if push protection is enabled, users are prevented from pushing commits containing new secrets. By the way, you can define exceptions or decide that a secret is allowed to be pushed to the repository anyway. The list of all supported secrets is defined in this URL. So this list is in the regular GitHub documentation and quite extensive. Note that if you have also a product that should go to this list, you may contact Microsoft and become a partner for the area of secret scanning patterns. Now, when you get aware of secrets, this requires you to define a process how to handle such a finding. This is something we recommend that you do in advance and define who is able to decide what and how to progress if something needs to be revoked. Let's see how we do this in practice. I go to the Settings tab. From here, I scroll down to Code Security and Analysis. Then I scroll down to the GitHub Advanced Security part and there to Secret Scanning. I enable this. And I also enable push protection. And I'm going to define a custom pattern for a custom secret. Click on New Pattern, enter the name as well as the specific format you'd like to have. In my case, this will be every string that starts with PWD underscore. You have also the option to test this. For example, and if you're happy with everything, you can save and start a dry run. The dry run, the results will be sent to your email inbox. Let's head back to our repository. While waiting for GitHub to find the secrets, let's add some additional secrets we defined with this special PWD pattern. I'll add them here. One, we have the value as a variable, and we have another value that's just a command. Let's commit. And head back to our project. By now, we've received the result from the dry run of our new pattern. At start time, we had no PWD underscore secrets within our code, so it didn't find anything. We can now go to the results and publish this rule. By By now, this rule is active. Let's see what the results say. I go to the security tab and here to secret scanning. And we see that it identified our two test strings.
But Paddy, when I look now at the controller Java file, I see many secrets in there. Why haven't we found more of these secrets? Why have we only found the secrets with your custom pattern?
Well, that's due to the list we previously saw in the web interface. So the predefined list of secrets that was defined by GitHub. As things stand, this Akaya, for example, is not there, but Azure secrets are contained in that list. So let us add an Azure secret as well as one of our defined patterns matching secrets, and then try out push protection of GitHub. I go back into our code and add the following lines. And I commit.
But wait a moment, Paddy. You just committed and pushed your changes, the secrets, into the source code repository.
Yes, exactly.
But we have enabled push protection. How can that happen?
It, in fact, shouldn't. But browsing through the internet, we found the following. So it says on the website that this push protection is actually better. And it looks like it's there in the user interface, but not yet working as of speaking in real life. Now let's see in the security tab, secret scanning. And in here, we at least have found the secrets. And what we at least get is the message that a secret is compromised and that we should rotate and revoke the secret.
What we, of course, did with that Azure storage account access key. So with that, we're at the end of this video where we showed you how to build in the secret protection in GitHub. We saw that secret protection is built in GitHub. We also saw that the coverage of the secret protection is not that big and it does not find all of the secrets. We also saw that push protection, due to that it is still beta, does not yet work, which would be a very good thing. But nevertheless, it is a very good thing. It is good implemented and it is good practice for your project to enable secret protection in GitHub. And with that, we are at the end of this video. In our next video, we will have a look at DAST, which is Dynamic Application Security Testing.